cooking.
It's funny, you know, my single Intuition is probably the poppiest song I've written. It's really a pop song. It's a well-crafted pop song with pop melodies. But the lyrics are really, you know, it talks about, you know, a lot of pop culture. It's really taking a tongue-in-cheek. like the lyrics, you know, they say Miss J's big butt is boss, now Kate Moss can't find a job. In a world of postmodern fad, what was good now is bad. It's not hard to understand, just follow the simple plan. Follow your heart, follow your intuition. It will lead you in the right direction. The whole song's about sort of media, media saturation, and being able to step away from that and get back to your instincts and your intuition and what guides you there. So it's fascinating to me, you know, like to put a really pop song with lyrics like that. And I don't know, I'm endlessly amused by doing that. I like that challenge, it's hard to do. This record to me is really a natural extension. It makes a lot of sense to me. It doesn't sound that different to me. I began writing songs when I was 16 and I heard this kind of stuff in my head. I didn't have the skill to do it on guitar. My first record was what I was able to get out of my head through my hands. My hands weren't as skilled as my thoughts were in a way, musically. So over the years, of course, I've learned more about the craft, more about how to write, more about music, more about chords, more about playing, more about lyrics. And so I've been able to finally kind of further embellish the ideas I kind of started with a long time ago.
You think the one with the feather.
I've always been really interested in all kinds of music. You know, I loved hip hop and rap when it, you know, when it, in the 80s, you know, when it was like exciting and new. And I love the beats and I love the rhythms. I like dance music a lot. I think it's really exciting. I like the hypnotic nature of dance music. There's something very primordial about it.
Disco lights and buff bodies are nice.
And I love folk music. You know, I love lyrics, I love storytelling, I love socially driven music. But what I tried to do with this record is combine all those different kinds of things, an element of each of those things, and make it make sense. You know, folk melodies against hip-hop beats, against a French accordion, against hand clapping and whistling solos. It's odd, an odd combination of a lot of styles of music, but it still really sounds like me.
Say hello. The boom where the body's jumping, where the boys all freak cause the boots are bumping, where the girls are naughty and always saying, yes you can, 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 yes you can. For you I give for free.
That's a gift.
With this record, I had a really specific goal that I haven't had with any other record, and that was to have it be fun. This record is fun to listen to. It makes you want to dance, and it makes you want to move, and it makes you feel young, and it makes you feel passionate, and it makes you feel alive. And that's something I wanted to inspire in myself and in people. And I used that using rhythm.
I think every song is really strong on this album. Every song is a potential single, which is kind of rare. I wouldn't say there's a filler song. And every song is totally different from the next.
There's a song called Leave the Lights On that is, basically what I said, it's a very sexy song. You can leave the lights on. It's a very, very sexy. There's a lot of very sexual songs on this record. I'm known for the acoustic guitar, for sure. I think when you think of Jewel, you think of the acoustic guitar. But I embrace technology. I love it. I love any color that allows me to paint the portrait I want. So I have no reservations about that.
I hear the clock, 6 a.m. Feels so far from where I've been. I got my eggs, my pancakes too. Got the maple syrup, everything but you. I break the yolks and make a smiling face. I kinda like it in my brand new place. I wipe the spots of the meal. Don't leave the keys in the door. Never put wet towels on the floor anymore. didn't want to talk, so I picked up the paper. It was more bad news. My heart's being broken. My people been used. Put on my coil and pouring rain. I saw a movie, it just wasn't the same. Cause it was happy, I was sad. It made me miss you. Oh, so.
Everybody's creative process is very different. What people draw on to be an artist can be a lot of things. A lot of people will draw on anger and angst. Without that, they don't really feel like they have something to write with. Some people are very visceral. I'm a person that really draws, like my art comes from very deep, from a very still place. I come way inside myself. I don't go out and get out and need to feed on that, kind of to have things to write about. I sort of, for some reason, my process is much more inside. So things I write about tend to be quite sincere, whether I'm using irony or not to do that.
If you want my heart, you have to promise not to tear it.
I'd say the majority of the time, lyrics come to me with a melody attached. I'm not a lyricist that can write without a melody very easily. They're very, very connected. I wouldn't really necessarily know how to separate the two. Though sometimes a line will come to me and I'll know it'll be a hook. So be the writers I grew up admiring were honest writers. The writers I grew up admiring didn't use their art to make themselves seem better. They didn't use their art as propaganda to make themselves seem more glamorous, more honorable than they were. And as a result, when I read them, I could relate to them. I could look at myself and see similarities, good and bad. And so I made a promise with myself at quite a young age that I would be honest when I wrote.
Follow your heart, your intuition. It will lead you in the right direction.
I thought it would be really funny since Jules' image is so set up in a certain way. I mean, most people have a very kind of like granola, very, you know, natural image of her. So I thought this would, I thought doing something like this would really play off of it big time. And she was totally game. I mean, she kept wanting to go more and more over the top with it and really just, you know, just go for it all. So that's what we're doing.
Video's really over the top. I mean, they're doing things in this video I never thought I'd do. Like, you know, I'm dancing, spray down with fire hoses, you know. It's sort of just, it's silly, you know, it's silly and completely over the top and something you would absolutely see in a music video, you know, which is the insane thing.
A lot of the sexy outfits in the video are done in jest. It's done as a parody of rap videos, of runways, of pop culture. It's been fun, you know, it's been fun to be sexy. You know, I have this incredible glam squad. My hair and makeup and stylist are the top in the business, and all they ever get to do is put me in jeans and brush my hair straight. So it's been weird. It was weird doing it. Like, I've been on stage in front of 60,000 people, and my heart was racing the night I had to do, like, my first little black dress with the jewel sign behind me. Freaking out. I mean, like, I had to dance and move and, like, be sexy, and so it was so I did it seriously without laughing and cracking up. I had to like take my robe off and there's traffic behind me and my butt's hanging out. It was so embarrassing. Oh God.
This crosswalk, just a regular street crosswalk, turns into a fashion runway. And Jewel struts her stuff up and down it. What else do we got here? Then we got this, then we got a really cool like soda ad where Jewel is just kind of sitting with a bottle of soda, but suddenly the camera goes in on her and the wind blows her shirt open, exposing her breast, and she sips the soda, doing something kind of, you know, really kind of, really like a bit of like commercial exploitation.
As defined by Webster, intuition is that beautiful and mysterious feeling you get from another place that guides you, I'd say. It's different than instinct. Instinct is more animalistic, and I think it's more a body, and intuition has more to do with something ephemeral and divine, I'd say.
I think the people will be really surprised because I think that she's a lot more different than I think her public images. I think she has a huge sense of humor, an incredible sense of humor, which I don't think a lot of people would think that she had. I know I didn't. I think that she has a really sexy side, and not that she hasn't looked good in her videos before, but I think doing something like this is, you know, certainly taking it to much more of an extreme than she's gone. So, I don't know, she's full of surprises.
Thank you. not quite sure. Am I it or could you get more? You learn cool from magazines. You learn love from Charlie Sheen. If you want me, let me know. I promise I won't say no. Follow your heart, your intuition. It will lead you in my direction. Let go of your mind, your intuition. It's easy to find, just follow your heart, baby. You got something that you're wanting to sell. Sell your sin, just cash in. Want me, don't play games. I promise it won't be in vain. Follow your heart, your intuition. It will lead you in my direction. Let go of your mind, your intuition. It's easy to find, just follow your heart, baby. Just follow your heart.
This music showcase presentation was brought to you by your Greater Philadelphia KFC restaurants. Want a fresh idea for eating better? You got a KFC, what's cooking?